So it is Friday. It is Friday night. I'm sitting in the NRG Stadium press box, and I get a direct message on Twitter. He's finishing up. It's like 12:30, and he's finishing up video editing, and I get a message on Twitter from Jack Dallas, the West Orange Star quarterback, and it says, it's kind of panic, says, "Hey man, do you have a number I can call about getting my letter jacket? I left it in the locker room." I go, oh my gosh. I look around, and Kate Hector, who is the communications director for UIL, who is fabulous, but she was gone at that point because she has spent way too much time there. She's gone. The whole UIL crew is gone. And so I say, okay, well, where is it? And he kind of tells me where the locker room is. Tells me where the locker room is. And he goes, I'll see if I can go down and get it. And so I go down, I'm looking through the locker room, and sure enough, I find Jack Dallas's letter jacket. And so there's only one thing that you can do at a time like this, and that is to hold that letter jacket hostage.
Ransom. Time to have a ransom. Have to.
Which is why we are so glad to be joined on DCTF Live by the quarterback of the West Orange Stark Mustangs and the owner of a really nice letter jacket.
And MVP of the state championship
offensive
game.
MVP. It is Jack Dallas. Hey, Jack.
How you guys doing?
We are doing just fine. So you got your letter jacket back, and we kind of held it ransom for it. So how in the world do you leave your letter jacket behind in a title game or at a title game locker room?
Oh, well, when you're celebrating, you're not really thinking about your letterman jacket. You're just thinking about celebrating with your boys. So I put it in the bad spot. So that was dumb on me.
Well, I will say we remarked on this in the press box that honestly it was probably the right move to tweet me because I'm always on Twitter.
Yes.
And you probably knew I was there. So that was really keeping your head on a swivel. Congratulations, obviously, on the victory over Salina. I want to go back to last year where you guys come up a bit short against a very good Gilmer team. What was the message from Coach Thompson? What was the message from the leaders on that team coming off the field at AT&T Stadium after a loss to Gilmer?
Oh, the guys were just there was very few underclassmen playing in that game, but the ones that were, they wanted us to come back and finish the job, and they truly believed that we could come back and do it. They told us, I mean, we all witnessed the grind that they put in, and we did the same thing this offseason, and it paid off.
It is Jack Dallas, the quarterback of the West Orange Stark Mustangs, the champion West Orange Stark Mustangs, the offensive MVP of the 4A Division II state title game, joining us here on DCTF Live. Get involved in the conversation. Hashtag DCTF Live. So going into the Salina game, you know you're going up against a very good opponent. What was the offensive game plan to attack what was a very good Salina defense?
Well, we knew from the very jump we had to dominate up front. If our line could win at the line of scrimmage, we knew we had a very good chance to win this game. And our offensive line most definitely showed up for this game. And they gave me the time I needed when we needed to throw the ball, and they opened up the holes for the running backs to run the ball.
And, of course, on the other side, it seems like your defense really, really, you know, obviously Salina loses their quarterback, but regardless, yeah, the defense really stood up for you standing on the sideline, watching that defense operate. How are you feeling when you're watching this defense kind of take apart what's a very good Salina attack?
Oh, I mean, when they're stopping them every drive, it takes a whole bunch of pressure off your offense. When they only allow 3 points, it's hard for us to not go out there and score a touchdown. I mean, when your defense is playing that hard, you want to score for them, and that's they worked their tail off this week, and it showed off, only allowing 3 points.
What was the celebration like either that night or when you guys got back to Orange?
When we got back to Orange, we pulled in the parking lot like we do every week, and our whole school parking lot was filled with cars, parents' cars, friends' cars, and it was just a huge celebration. The community, it was awesome. We had an escort back into town. It was unbelievable.
It was. I imagine the party went on for quite a while. And of course, you were named. You were named the offensive MVP of the game, and did a lot of damage both with your arms and arm and your legs. For you to be named the offensive MVP of the title game, what does that honor mean for you?
Oh, it means it's a credit to the whole team, for one. Those guys, we truly were a team this year. Not one guy could do its job without another guy performing its job. And for me to be named, it's a huge honor, but the whole team deserved that trophy and that MVP. We all worked hard for that.
And, of course, this isn't West Orange Stark's first rodeo. This is a program with a lot of pedigree and a program that has a lot of expectations. And you had a lot of those guys kind of on the sidelines and in the stands. You know, Kevin Smith, of course, I talked to on Fox Sports Southwest at one point. How do you handle that kind of not just pressure but kind of expectations from a program that has been there, done that, and has championship aspirations?
Well, it's a lot of motivation. When you're walking around town, you hear everybody talking about the season, what they want, and what they expect. When you lose a game, you're going to hear about it as well. It's just we're expected to win every year, and when you don't, everybody's a little surprised. And there's definitely an added pressure to go out there and win every week. But at the end of the day, it's a high school football game, and we're enjoying ourselves and having a great time out there.
Yeah, and you guys had quite a crowd. I got to say, Max, I don't know if you felt the same way.
Best crowd. Best crowd of the first 2 days.
Yeah, the first 2 days, that was probably the biggest. The crowd that maybe was the most turnt on
Orange.
Yeah.
Turned out. Orange turned out, man.
So is it like that every weekend?
I wouldn't say every weekend. All the local area teams, when they eventually lose out of the playoffs, you kind of see the different school colors showing up, popping up in the crowd, and it's awesome. Each and every week, the crowd gets a little bit bigger. In the state game, you would have thought about the whole city of Orange was there. It was great.
Yeah, they were out in force. It's Jack Dallas. He's the quarterback of the West Orange Stark Mustangs, joining us on DCTF Live.
And he has the best football name.
Yeah, let's talk
in
about
the state.
This.
We need to talk about
let's,
this.
Let's talk. We would be remiss if we didn't bring up the fact that your name is Jack Dallas. Do you sometimes feel like a secret agent?
No, not really.
Yeah, it's just you don't see. How often do you get comments like that about your name? Because it's a very unique kind of
Texan
Friday Night Lights, type name. How often do you get comments about your name?
Daily. People they really like the name. They think it's catchy. Every time I'm in a different city, my last name changes. Every time I'm in a different city in Texas, my last name changes pretty much.
So you were Jack Houston on
I was
Friday?
Jack Houston on Friday. Mm-hmm. Coming through Beaumont, I was Jack Beaumont. Just whatever I happened to be.
We have very stupid names, so it's
for sure. But I'm curious. Well, although I will say I get a lot of, you know, people always ask me Maximilian, huh? Well, what's up with that? So, what do your parents say about naming you Jack Dallas when people ask?
Well, I mean, I got to give all the credit to them. They did a great job apparently on naming me.
That's great job. Yeah, keeping your head on a swivel there, mom and dad.
They brought their A game for their name giving. I'll give them that.
All right. So now let's look forward. Obviously, you guys, you're just a junior. You will be back next year as the quarterback of the West Orange Stark Mustangs. And now, obviously, you're only a couple days removed from a title, but it's never too early to start talking about 2016. You guys are going to
be in
a very different situation. Whereas this year you had to replace a lot of pieces, it seems to me you're going to have a lot coming back for next year. How does that change how you go about your business?
Well, we're going to go through the off season as we do every year. We're not going to have to replace too many starting seniors, which is awesome because chemistry stays the same. You can work out the same plays and just you keep everything the same. It's just the grind for this offseason, we're going to have to stay more focused because our goal is definitely to repeat next year.
He is Jack Dallas. He's the quarterback of the state champion West Orange Stark Mustangs, the 4A Division II state champions. You can follow him on Twitter at JackDallas7. Jack, appreciate you hopping on with us. Congratulations, and I'm very glad you got your jacket back.
Oh, yeah. Thank you guys so much. Thank you for having me on.